Hi everyone and welcome back to our channel. Today we have another legendary story to share with you. Get ready to be amazed as we dive into more fascinating facts in the world of the Carpenters. So grab some popcorn and let's get started. Don't you remember you told me you loved me, baby? You said you'd be coming back again, baby. What if I told you that success begins in the most unexpected places? Well, that's exactly what happened with the Carpenters. It all started in New Haven, a small suburban town in Connecticut, where Richard and Karen grew up, in a modest house on 55 Hall Street in East Haven. It was here that Richard would eventually begin piano lessons. Karen Carpenter, a talented drummer and vocalist, and Richard Carpenter, a gifted pianist and songwriter, embarked on their incredible journey together. Their unique sound and undeniable chemistry soon caught the attention of the music industry professionals. By April the 29th, 1969, exactly 1 week after signing with A&M Records, Richard and Karen were in the label's Studio B, recording the first Carpenter album, Offering.
Carpenters, creating music, creating magic, in their first album called Offering.
I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today. Yeah.
One of the things that made the Carpenters truly stand out was their ability to fuse different genres and experiment with multi-layered arrangements.
But you and I will be doing all the parts. You'll be singing the lead, and we'll both be doing the harmony like this.
Don't be afraid to love and get love returned. Don't be afraid to tell everyone you. Sunshine and joy. Don't be afraid to give all you've got to give. One of these days you'll find that's the way to live. And living is what we all were put on this earth to do. So come on and live and be happy. Don't be afraid to
While the Carpenters' success skyrocketed, their personal lives were not without challenges. Richard battled quaalude addiction, which resulted in the Carpenters cancelling all further touring in 1978. And a year later, Richard went into treatment to cure his dependency on the drug and won the fight.
As the years went on and things became a little more troubling in our careers, I was not sleeping well. And Mom said, well, why don't you try one of these things? My doctor said quaalude. They're called by most people quaaludes or eludes. For years, I took pretty much one a night, and they got the job done.
Meanwhile, Karen faced her battle with anorexia nervosa, a disorder that plagued her for many years.
There were rumors, though, that you were suffering from the Slimmer's disease, from anorexia nervosa. Is that right?
No, I was just pooped.
But you did get
tired out.
You went down to about 6 stone in weight, I think, didn't you?
I have no idea what 6 stone in weight is.
66 pounds, it's very difficult to work out. I think about 84 pounds
no.
or something like that. No.
No.
She wasn't so lucky. On the 4th of February, 1983, she died of heart failure due to complications from anorexia, bringing shock and sadness to their fans and the music industry as a whole. Despite the immense loss, the legacy of the Carpenters lives on. And there you have it, the remarkable journey of the Carpenters, from their humble beginnings in Connecticut to becoming global stars. Their story is one of passion and perseverance. Thank you for joining us today. If you've enjoyed the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more stories. Until next time, take care and keep on grooving to the soulful tunes of the Carpenters.
Don't you remember you told me you loved me, baby? You said you'd be coming back.